Hello everyone, my name is Shehzad Khan, working in New Catholic Mission School, Jhabua. Going to teach you chapter 6th of subject science of class 7, that is physical and chemical changes. Without wasting much time, let's begin our PPT. As you all know, we are having so much changes surrounding in our environment that are physical and chemical changes. Those changes which reduces size and shape, but they are on their original entity, they are called physical changes. And those changes who are going to elaborate or modify themselves into a new specified object, they are called chemical changes. Every day you come across many changes in your surroundings. These changes may involve one or more substances. For example, your mother may ask you to dissolve sugar in water to make a cold drink. Making a sugar solution is a change. Similarly, setting curd from milk is a change. Sometimes milk becomes sour. Soaring of milk is a change. Stretched rubber band also represents a change. Broadly, these changes are of two kinds, which are chemical and physical. Clear? These are some examples which elaborate more beautifully about the physical and chemical changes. Let's begin to physical change. Properties such as shape, size, color, and the state of a substance are called its physical properties. A change in which a substance undergoes a change in its physical properties is called a physical change. A physical change is generally reversible, whereas chemical change is irreversible. In such a change, no new substance is formed. Two things will be very much important for you in this physical change, that is, it is reversible and no new substance is formed. That is a piece of paper or a paper, full paper size, which will be cut into a smaller size, but it is again represent into its original condition, that is paper. No new any substance form, only shape and size will be changed. Here is now chemical change. A change with which you are quite familiar is the rusting of iron. Very much common changes available in our gardens or in our parking lots. If you leave a piece of iron in the open for some time, it acquires a film of brownish substance. This substance is called rust. And the process is called rusting. A change in which one or more new substances are formed is called a chemical change. A chemical change is also called as chemical reactions because it is in between two new substances or form a new substance. This is rusting of iron. Here is a plate given there which is full of rust. It is an open source available. Then what is rusting of iron is? Let us get back to rusting. This is one change that affect iron articles, say particles, and slowly destroys them. Since iron is used in making bridges, ships, cars, trucks, bodies, and many other articles, the monetary loss due to rusting is huge. This process of rusting can be represented by the following equations. Iron, in short, that is Fe, chemical name, then oxygen, O2, that is from the air side, then water, which is present in humidity, which kill iron oxide, it is rust, Fe2O3. For rusting, the presence of both oxygen and water or water vapor is essential. Two things are very much important for rusting any metals, that is oxygen and water. Prevention iron particles from coming in contact with oxygen or water or both. One simple way is to apply a coat of paint or grease. In fact, these coats should be applied regularly to prevent rusting. Another way is to deposit a layer of metal like chromium or zinc or iron. This process of depositing a layer of zinc on iron is called galvanization, that is here. The iron pipes we use in our homes to carry water are galvanized to prevent rusting. They are prepared from the company or the factory or the industry ready-made galvanized pipe because we have to make the sure of that water will be evacuated with the help of rusting. Then the changes can be represented by the following equations of here, that is magnesium ribbon burning. So this is a equation shows the magnesium, that is Mg, chemical name oxygen, which will be converted to magnesium oxide. Here is another example, that is copper sulfate. Razor will be here. We can write reaction as copper sulfate, that is solution, that is blue, plus iron, which will be converted to iron sulfate solution green, and copper, that is brown, will be deposited on this blade. Change in color of the copper sulfate solution due to reaction with iron. Then another reaction also is here. The change in the test tube is as follows. Vinegar, that is already available in our home, acetic acid. Then baking soda, it is also available at our home. Then carbon dioxide and other substances. We should define that the reaction between carbon dioxide and lime water is as कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड CO2, लाइम वाटर CaOH2, विच इज डिफरेंट टू कैल्शियम कार्बोनेट CaCO3 एंड वाटर विल बी हियर. सो दिस इक्वेशंस कैन बी इजीली पास थ्रू द सेटअप विद द लाइम वाटर. नाउ समटाइम्स वी आर गेटिंग न्यूज ऑफ दैट इज क्रिस्टलाइजेशन. इन क्लास 6 यू हैव लर्न दैट सॉल्ट कैन बी ऑब्टेन बाय द इवोपरेशन ऑफ सी वाटर एज इट्स अ केमिकल रिएक्शन बट इट इज अ नेचुरल प्रोसेस. The salt obtained in this manner is not pure and its crystals are small. The shape of the crystals cannot be seen clearly. However, large crystals of pure substance can be formed from their solutions. The process is called crystallization. It is an example of physical change also. But there is a new substance formed. Clear? So I hope so that you will get a proper and brief definition about physical and chemical changes what are to be going in surrounding our atmosphere. And you have to take proper help with your parents, with your family, in your societies, that what are changes in which you are adopting this kind of properties, in which new substances are formed, new substances are not formed, which substances are reversible, which substances are not reversible. So you can identify yourself what are physical changes and what are chemical changes. Thank you.